Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Karting with Chris. Today is the pre-final for the Fall 2 race. So in qualifying, we qualified 9th out of 21 people. So a little bit above the middle of the pack. You don't want to be in the back of the pack because that's usually where all the wrecks happen. So when you're a rookie, you have to start in the back. And this is my first race as a non-rookie. And it's just so much nicer not to have to pass all these people who are slower than you and, you know, not have people crashing into you. But I will say the top five people in today are ranked nationally. So, you know, I'm not saying they have an advantage, because that's not an advantage. It's just they're better than me, and it's not going to bring me down. I don't care. So, starting 9th, we have the inside line going into turn 1, which is a really big deal. You'll see in this video, the guy in 2nd gets a really... he didn't get a bad start, but since he's on the outside going into turn 1, he falls back a lot. And you'll be able to see it. So we're going through turn 7 here, side by side. We're all serious. Usually there's a bit of fist bumping, saying good luck. But today we're all serious. Gotta win this race. Going through the last corner here. Get right on the bumper of the guy in front of me. But it's kind of hard to tell when the leader starts. So I wasn't able to get as close as I would to the guy in front of me, but we're green and we're going. So the guy next to me gets a really good start, and we're able to pass 2 people within the first corner. So that's what the inside line gives you, 2 people past the first corner. Going through turn 3 here, we do have the outside line because there is someone next to us, and then we lose 2 more spots. So we're back where we started. Let's see if we can gain any positions. Side by side through the chicane, a little scary. And then the guy right here on my left, that's the guy who started in 2nd. So you can see how far back he came just because he's on the outside. So now we've dropped down to 11th. The guy in front of me is Adrian Cruz. A week before we had another race and he won it. So we're gonna try and follow him because he's a really good driver. So we watch this guy and he just falls off the face of Earth. That guy, I guess, decided he'd had enough. One lap was good enough, and he didn't want to do anything else. So we gained a position there. Let's see if we can gain some more. We get a pretty bad exit coming out of turn 3, and you can see how fast they pull away. So I didn't have the best start for this race, but we're going to see if we can maybe catch up, because there is a bit of feuding going on here. We are able to catch up through these corners, but not enough to be anywhere close to a move. You can see the guy in front right there in the white, not the green helmet, the guy right here, number 2. He qualified really well, but he was just struggling through this race. Maybe his kart was not set up properly, so we're able to pass him and take 9th, right back where we started. That pass really slowed us down, and now the people in front are pulling away. And we're going to try and see if we can catch up to them. The best way to, you know, really pass people is to be right on their bumpers the entire time and wait for them to make a mistake, or at least pressure them into a mistake. Since that last pass, they kind of pulled away from me, and so I'm not quite on their bumpers anymore. And when you're on their bumper, you also get a nice draft. And that can also help you to pass them. Or what some people do is they'll push the guy in front of them, and that'll make them both faster. And they'll catch up to the group in front of them so they can both have a chance at winning. Because if you're constantly fighting, then you won't have a chance of winning, like zero chance. So we're going to try and hope that they start fighting, but usually people like this don't fight a lot. And then I saw this out of the corner of my eye. That guy was either the guy who exploded earlier and somehow managed to survive it, or that's just a backmarker who spun out or something. So we gotta watch out for people like backmarkers who spun out and they're really far behind, because sometimes they can wipe you out. In the senior division, like I run in the senior division, usually that doesn't happen. But in the lower divisions, like juniors, you'll see a lot of times the backmarker, they don't do it on purpose, but they'll just turn into one of the faster guys. So we gotta watch out for that. So we are on lap 6, and we are noticing that they may be slowly pulling away, but it's not a whole lot. And the guy in green, like the guy right in front of me, he's just passing a guy in red, and that guy, he got a really good start, but I looked at my times, and he was about a quarter of a second slow. So what happened was, he's the guy who actually started beside me, I believe, and he got such a good start. He got up to second, I think is what he told me, and then he just didn't have the pace, and he was slowly dropping back. So our hope is to catch up with this guy and maybe pass him. We only have 2 laps left, so it's gonna be really close, if not impossible. So we're coming up to the last lap up here. So this is turn 7. After this, we only got a couple more corners and then we're on the last lap. We just gotta hope he messes up or he goes for a move on the guy in front of him and you know, it doesn't work, and then he slows down, because he's about 2 or 3 seconds ahead. He's really far ahead. So we're going full throttle through the first corner, tiny lift through the second, then full throttle again, brake at the rumble strips going into turn 3, and then give it gas, and then full throttle through the chicane up here. And then what you do is you lean forward to make yourself more aerodynamic. Brake on the rumble strips at the right, turn in, track out, and then up here do a tiny lift and then full gas. And it looks like it's not enough to get 8th. So we're finishing 9th, and that's where we started, so not bad. So this is all I have for you guys. There is a part 2. It's gonna be the final race. It's gonna be a little bit more interesting than this. I suggest you go and check it out. If you have any opinions or suggestions or questions about this video, please comment below. And if you like the video, please subscribe. Thank you guys for watching, and have a good day.